It's made such a tremendous difference in my life. I'm a whole different person.
I can now see the bigger picture.
I'm much more mellow.
Is Prozac really all it's cracked up to be?
Safe, it's effective, and it works.
It's the now thing.
Something new for the 90s.
The quick fix solution.
Tonight, is everything as good as it seems in...
Funding for Frontline is provided by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. And by annual financial support from viewers like you. This is Frontline.
There's a town in Washington State where people are wondering about what it takes to be happy.
That's life. That's what all the people say. You're riding high, a Negro, shot down and made. But I don't give a damn for life's tune. When I'm back on top, back on top in June.
Good morning, Wenatchee. Good times, great oldies. That's 99 KXA with Solem in the Morning, along with Gary Patrick. How you doing, Gary?
Doing great.
Coming to you from the heart of Washington State, the Apple Capital of the World, now known... as Happy Valley.
Yeah, that's right.
The Prozac capital of the world.
The antidepressant pill everyone's talking about.
And you're listening to Wenatchee's alternative to Prozac. As a matter of fact, we are prescription-free.
Absolutely. 24 hours a day.
So take a dose. The doctor is in.
You wonder who in town has got as many problems I have to take the medication.
Well, I don't know. You know, the Valium... furor that was going on a few years ago. There were a lot of people on Valium. Yeah. They don't hear much about that anymore.
Yeah. I tried one of those Valiums on my dog once. It was getting out of hand. It worked wonders.
Did it work?
Oh, yeah. It didn't work in my wife, but it sure worked in the dog good. Maybe I can try some of this Prozac on my cat now. He's getting kind of testy.
Wenatchee is a small town where people are sometimes unhappy. More unhappy than anywhere else? No one knows for sure. What makes Wenatchee different is apples, and the man known as the Pied Piper of Prozac. Dr. Jim Goodwin is a clinical psychologist. He's diagnosed all 700 of his clients with depression and referred them to physicians for Prozac. He takes the medicine himself for his own depression.
I was nothing. I would go into these black holes, and I felt worthless. I felt I was no good. I felt I'd been in the military. I'd killed people. I was just feeling so guilty and so terrible, and I wanted to die. It was real, real painful. And now, before I was admitted to this army hospital, I felt so bad that I drove to a garbage dump and took a big old fighting knife that I had from Vietnam at K-Bar and started... I cut my wrist here, and I cut my wrist there, and I stuck the blade. It's a Bowie-type knife with twin blades on it, and I pulled. I remember pulling out the vein and cutting that, and pulling out the vein and cutting that, and I just remember standing there and trying to wipe it off, but it kept coagulating. I wasn't thinking real straight. I couldn't. There was no alcohol in me. There was no pain. I just remember wanting to die and standing out there. Prozac didn't come into the picture until about 1988, 89. They hadn't used it very much at that point in time in the military. But we tried it, and I'll tell you, after being on it for about 2 to 3 weeks, I popped out of the depression, and it was real enlightenment. For me, it was like walking around like this for my whole life and really not knowing that I was nearsighted. I mean, really. I mean, no one had ever offered me glasses. And then all of a sudden, here comes... somebody that says, okay, now try these on, try this Prozac on. And I tried it on, and for the first time in my life, I went, whoa, is this the way reality really is?
With his sight restored, Dr. Jim Goodwin has had a vision. A town liberated from depression by Prozac. But he's drawn to Wenatchee, the medication's harshest critic, a man not only against Prozac, but against all psychiatric drugs. Psychiatrist Peter Breggin.
Well, we have here a kind of microcosm of America right now. America has been pushed more and more by the psychiatrists of the country and by the drug companies of the country to turn to medication. Eli Lilly put on a giant campaign and still has a giant campaign going on in this country selling the idea of depression and drugs to America. Well, Wenatchee has bought the campaign. And so we see here a microcosm of what it looks like if you really take seriously the kind of propaganda that's been handed out in America. Now, the fact that we have an extremist psychologist who has now admitted that he gives everyone in his practice the same drug and gives everyone the same therapy basically just shows how you can exaggerate the basic themes that are already going on in America. Listen to me, the authority. I'll tell you what's the matter. I'll rescue you. I'll give you the quick fix solution, the American way.
I should never have had depression in the first place. I should never have to take Prozac. I should never do this. Have you been shooting all over yourself for a number of years?
Yes.
Sure you have. You've been shooting all over yourself. But not only have you been shooting all over yourself, you've been doing something even worse, Sandy. You've been, and I don't want to share this with the rest of the world, but you've been masturbating a lot.
I have?
Yes, you have. You've been masturbating all over the place. Well, no, Sandy, no, you have. You've been masturbating. What's masturbating? All right, let's say, A, I've got $11. My B is I'd like to have at least 12. Now I'm going to begin to masturbate. Now watch what happens to my body. Here I am, I'm walking down the street, got $11 in my pocket, but now instead of I'd like to have at least 12, now it's I must have at least 12.
Getting a little red.
Okay, now.
You're foaming at the mouth.
I'm foaming at the mouth. Lots of people in our society have used medicine to change the state of the human existence. There must be a reason why we eat so much candy, why we take so much alcohol, why we drink so much coffee, why we use so many mind-altering medicines. There must be a reason why we eat so much chocolate. Why do we have to keep altering? Because this inherently is just as fallible as my eyes might be. My eyes have glasses on them, just as fallible as my teeth are. My teeth have fillings on them, just as fallible as my knee. I'm a disabled vet. I wear a brace on my knee every once in a while. I'm a 20th century man. And if my brain needs something to help me function better, why not use it? I have seen hundreds and hundreds of people make incredible changes in their lives using this medicine as an adjunct along with the therapy. I take the medicine myself. I've been through it myself. If my children needed it, I would have no fear. Or if my wife did, in suggesting that they take it. It's a medicine that probably is less toxic than salt.
Prozac is supposed to be a whole new generation of antidepressants. It blocks the removal of a particular brain chemical called serotonin from the brain connections. Serotonin is like a spark between brain cells. There's maybe 100 similar kinds of sparks with different names. And the idea behind it is to make the sparks stay longer and more active in the brain. And so the removal is blocked by Prozac, the removal of the serotonin. Basically, you're jazzing up one of the neurotransmitters of the brain. Now, the argument is that it's selective. It's called a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, an SSRI, a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor. And that's the sales pitch, that this is very selective. But the theory makes very little sense. It's too global. And in addition, when you try to do something to the brain, like jack up a neurotransmitter system, you're not just affecting that system. The other neurotransmitters react. The brain has at least 3 known compensatory mechanisms whereby it tries to shut down the very effect that the drug is trying to produce. You get this complicated hodgepodge of interactions that we can't even begin to understand. So theoretically, we don't really know what we're doing when we dump junk into this complex organ called the brain.
You've been masturbating all over yourself, you've been shooting all over yourself, mm-hmm. and your body has been changing and your world has been changing around all this. Now, a lot of people ask me, well, Jim, I'm understanding that. Why would I masturbate? Why would I shoot all? Why would I do that to myself? There's a real simple reason. Because your brain chemistry is off. You've got a physical illness called depression. Yeah. You can't help it. You can't help it. And when you have a physical illness called depression, there's an electrochemical imbalance in your body that causes you to do this. Mm-hmm. And the funny thing is that you begin to experience a thing that we call automatic negative thinking. Now, I'm an old military man. I like acronyms. Automatic negative thoughts. You know what I like to call them? Ants. Automatic negative thoughts.
Oh.
You know what you've had inside of your head? A bunch of ants.
Life has been tough from the beginning. Read the Old Testament. To call it depression is to trivialize it. That's the real trivialization, is to give it a medical diagnosis. This is the human condition, to struggle, to find meaning, to find love, to share, to give, to take, to face death. These are the things that religion struggles with, that psychology struggles with, and to call it a medical disorder is to trivialize it and to destroy the very fabric of what life is about.
You wonder how something like that gets started, you know? Is there some vast organization that said, let's go to Wenatchee and see what this Prozac's about? I'm sure that the doctors here aren't the only one prescribing it.
It just takes one aggressive guy to make something happen, apparently. Apparently we have them here.
Yeah. Well, if we can work it around to sell apples, it'd be great.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum.
Across America, 11 million people have now tried Prozac. And most everyone's heard about it.
Still, it's a real good bet. The best is yet to come.
That's because a world away from Wenatchee in Providence, Rhode Island, in the late 1980s, psychiatrist Peter Kramer took note of the intriguing effect on his patients of a new antidepressant.
You think you've seen...
What struck me about Prozac forcefully when I started using it was the way in which patients used it to define the self. There were a couple of examples. One was the kind of patient who would say, I see this responds to the medicine, so this is biological happenstance about me, whereas the rest of me might still be autobiographical, carefully developed self. The other was the patient who would say, I feel like myself at last. This is my true self on the medicine. Whereas the patient might have been some other way, subtly different, for many years, and by implication would never have been herself had she not taken the medicine.
Kramer wrote a best-selling book about Prozac, a meditation on the drug and on his patients' transformations, transformations that hadn't occurred with standard psychotherapy.
I'm one of the people that Peter Kramer wrote about in his book. The kind of depression that I would go through was literally being on the floor, unable to get up, you know, and feeling a terrible sense of dread every morning when I'd get up. You know, my whole body would feel, I would physically feel limp. So I saw psychologists on and off throughout my adolescence. But I never really felt that they did anything much for me, even though I, you know, went pretty regularly. And I never, even now I would say, I don't really know what psychologists ever did for me. And it wasn't really the only thing that I'd ever say really made a difference, that I can without a doubt say made a difference, was going on antidepressant drugs.
It would be wonderful to think that trauma that comes about through emotional injury can be healed through emotional understanding, insight, and so on. And that might be true. I think in many cases it is true. But there may be traumas that result in very stable, hard-to-change biological alterations, alterations in the way the brain functions. And it may be that the most direct and kindest way to respond to those traumas is through medication.